morning.
Morning.
Welcome to our worship service this morning. We have a very special service today. Today is our youth service. Our entire worship service, minus the communion part, will be led by our youth here at St. Paul's, all ages, and we're really excited to see how that goes. In fact, we even have one of them running our computer today. And so we're very excited, and we ask that you keep in mind that they haven't done it before. And so, especially when we get to parts where we're citing things together, we'll probably be a little bit slower. But we're very excited. They've been practicing hard. We've got music by lots of different people. And so that'll be our service today. I do want to make a few announcements before we begin. Just a reminder that 2 weeks from today, not next Sunday, but 2 weeks from today, is our service at the Thorndike's Pond. So on August 30th, there will not be service here. We will be gathered together at the pond beginning at 10 a.m. and then followed by a pork chop luncheon and fellowship. There's fishing. There's all sorts of fun things to do there. Larry asked that I remind you that plates, silverware, cups, meat, drinks, all of that kind of stuff is provided. All you need to do is bring a side dish or a dessert to share with the group. That's 2 weeks from today. The other thing that I would like to just highlight, since so many of our youth and parents are here, September 13th is our God's Work, Our Hands Sunday. We will once again be gathering after church for our Sunday, where we have lunch and then we assemble our school kits and then have ice cream to celebrate doing that. So anybody is welcome to stay after church that Sunday and eat and help with the school kits and have some ice cream. So that'll be September 13th. Are there any other announcements this morning before I get to the prayer list?
This is for the kids and the choir members. On the back, on the tables in the parish hall, you know, the stacks of music. If anybody would be inclined after church, but before Sunday school starts, to help sort music, I think we could get the job done in about 10 minutes. By myself, it takes me half a day.
Great.
I can use readers.
Okay, readers still need a pass.
Well, September 11th and 12th is Prairie View coming around the corner, the Fall Festival, and we're one of the 28 churches that are responsible for doing things there. Our church has requested is six pies, and if anybody is willing to help to serve the fish on Friday night, and books, plants, fruit, vegetable, garden things, just about anything is can be donated and is sold there. So come and join and eat fish on Friday, and the pork chops I think is on Saturday. I'm not sure on Saturday. Put it on the counter.
All right.
Okay. I just want to let you know that Andy is home. He came home Friday, and we're doing real, real good. Thanks for all my prayers.
Are there any others? All right, then I do have a couple additions to the prayer list this morning. Forrest Smith, that's Butch's brother, has not been doing well. Many of you know he's been struggling with health problems for quite a while, but we will add him to our prayer list as they're trying to build some strength up in order to hopefully do some more testing. So we'll keep him in our prayers today and throughout the coming weeks. And then I have added Alan and Ethan Amolsch. This happens to be my uncle and cousin. My uncle has an infection in his heart, which is a bit concerning. Things are going well, but he's in the hospital. They're just outside of Detroit. And Ethan is his son, who normally is one of the ones that helps take care of him, but playing softball, he broke his ankle in three places. So he's currently had to have surgery and a pin and things like that. So I've just added them to our prayer list as they're continuing to recover from those items. So are there any other additions or updates for the prayer list? I see pointing. I'm not sure what.
I was pointing at the speaker.
Oh, the speaker? Am I?
It's, well, that's what I just
I was going to say.
Back.
It's going to be a bit of a challenge. We have three different microphones going, so hopefully it won't be too bad, but just so you're aware. All right, then we begin our worship service this morning actually with our prelude led by Reagan Vaughn.
Trinity, one God, the creator of wind, rain, field, and ocean, the bread of life coming down from above, and the power at work within us in this world. Before God in this company of our sisters and brothers, let us confess our sins. Alpha, God and the Father of all,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. We have thought better of ourselves than others. We have told lies, said hurtful things, acted in ways we wish we could take back, and looked the other way.
Everything old passed away. Everything became new in Christ. You are a new creation. Your sins are taken away, and you are made new. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ has forgiven you.
Amen.
Thank you.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Ever-loving God, your Son gives himself as living bread for the life of the world. Fill us with such knowledge and presence that we may be strengthened and experienced as life. Continually through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
First reading comes from Proverbs chapter 9, verse 1 through 6. Wisdom has built her house. She has hewn her seven pillars. She has slaughtered her animals. She has mixed her wine. She has also set her table. She has sent out her servant girls. She calls from the highest places in the town. You that are simple, turn in here. To those without sense, she says, come, eat of my bread and drink of the wine I have mixed. Lay aside immaturity and live, and walk in the way of insight. Here ends the first reading.
Thank you.
Fear the Lord, saints of the Lord, for those who fear the Lord lack nothing.
The lions are in want and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack nothing that is good.
Come, children, and listen to me. I will teach you reverence for the Lord.
Who among you takes pleasure in life and desires all life to enjoy prosperity?
Keep your tongue from evil and your lips from lying words.
Turn from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it.
The second lesson from the fifth chapter of Ephesians, verse 15 through 20. Act like people with good sense and not like fools. These are evil times, so make every minute count. Don't be stupid. Instead, find out what the Lord wants you to do. Don't destroy yourself by getting drunk. Let the Spirit fill your life. When you meet together, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. As you praise the Lord with all your heart, always use the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to thank God the Father for everything.
Okay, so I know I forgot to remind most of you to bring backpacks today, but I would like anyone who is beginning any kind of school this year to come up, and if you have a bag, you can bring it, and if not, still just come forward. And then I'd also like to invite any staff or volunteers or teachers or anyone who works, foundation board, anybody who works with the school systems, you're also invited to come forward because we have a blessing for you too. Oh, wonderful. And the backpacks that some of the kids have, the string ones you see, will be used for the school kits that will go across the world. So we'll be blessing those as they depart this year with Lutheran World Relief as well.
Does everyone have one?
Matt, are you going to want to screen? All right. There you go. All right. Students, we love you as you are. You are human, like all of us, capable of right and wrong. Yet we challenge you this school year to grow intellectually and spiritually, to be like Christ. You are our hope for the future church, and you are servants and leaders now. We believe in you. Remember through this year that your community here at St. Paul's and your God love you and want the very best for you in this school year. We will be praying for you when you are having fun at school and when you are not. We'll be praying for you when you are sick and home from school. We'll be praying for you when someone is mean to you. And we will be praying for you when you are not acting as you should. We will be praying for you when you struggle, when you feel left out, when you have the chance to stand up for yourself or a friend, and when you are tired of learning. We'll be praying for you as you play sports, take tests, perform in front of people, or hide in your room. And never forget that through it all, God is with you. Teachers, staff, administrators, coaches, we love you as you are. You are human like all of us and capable of right and wrong. Yet we challenge you this school year to grow intellectually and spiritually, to be like Christ. You are our hope for the future church. And you are our leaders and servants now. We believe in you. Remember through this year that your community here at St. Paul's and your God love you and want the best for you this school year. We'll be praying for you when you are having fun at school and when you are not. We'll be praying for you when you are sick and home from school. We'll be praying for you when someone is mean to you. We'll be praying for you when you are not acting as you should. We'll be praying for you when you struggle, when you feel left out, when you have the chance to stand up for yourself or a child, and when you are tired of teaching. We'll be praying for you as you lead sports, give tests, and get others to perform in front of people, or worry about those children who seem lost or hurt. Never forget that through it all, God is with you. God bless all of you at the beginning of another year of fruitful learning, exercises in patience, and ministry to the world through your words and your actions. Amen. Round of applause for all of our students and teachers and leaders.
Jesus said, "I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whom eats of this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh." The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us the flesh to eat?" So Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink the blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day, for my flesh is true food and blood and true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died, but the one who eats the bread will live forever."
Out before me.
"I want bread."
"How wise you are. Bread is what you need, and you have come to the right bakery."
So I pulled my cookbook down from the shelf and began to tell him all I knew about bread. I spoke of flour of wheat, of flour and wheat, of grain and barley. My knowledge impressed even me as I cited measurements in the recipe. When I looked up, I was surprised to see he wasn't smiling.
"I just want bread."
"How wise you are. Follow me and I'll show you the bakery."
Down the hallowed halls I guided him, pausing to point out the rooms where the dough is prepared and the ovens where the bread is baked.
"No one has such facilities. We have bread for every need, but here is the best part.
I proclaimed as I pushed open two swinging doors.
This is our room of inspiration.
I knew he was moved as we stepped into the auditorium full of stained glass windows. The beggar didn't speak. I understood his silence. With my arm around his shoulder, I whispered,
"It overwhelms me as well."
Then I leaped to the podium and struck my favorite pose behind the lectern.
People come from miles to hear me speak. Once a week, my workers gather and I read to them the recipe from the Cookbook of Life.
By now, the beggar had taken a seat on the front row. I knew what he wanted.
Would you like to hear me?
No, I just want some bread.
How wise you are.
And I led him to the front door of the bakery.
What I have to say to you next is very important.
I told him as we stood outside.
Up and down the street, you will find many bakeries, but take heed. They don't serve the true bread. I know one who adds two spoons of salt rather than one. I know of another whose oven is 3 degrees too hot. They may call it bread, but it's not according to the book.
The beggar turned and began walking away.
Don't you want bread?
He stopped, looked back at me and shrugged.
I guess I lost my appetite.
I shook my head and returned to my office.
What a shame, the world just isn't hungry for true bread anymore.
What bread is hunger? Jesus claims to be for the soul. Travel to almost any country and sit in any restaurant and they'll serve you bread. Bread is staple. If the poor have nothing, they have bread. If the rich have everything, they still have bread. Bread is not a regional food nor a national dish. No country claims to be exclusive source of bread. It may be in the form of a tortilla in Mexico or a bagel in New York. The bread is available everywhere. So is Christ, but is not bound by boundaries. No country claims him. No region owns him. No nation monopolizes him. He is everywhere at the same time, universally available. Bread is eaten daily. Some fruits are available only in season. Some drinks are made on holidays. Not so with bread, and not so with Jesus. He should be brought to our table every day. We let him nourish our hearts, not just with certain months or just on special events, but daily. I don't know what is more incredible, that God packages the bread of life in the wrapper of a country carpenter or that he gives us the keys to the delivery truck. Both moves seem pretty risky. The carpenter did this part, however, and who knows, we may just learn to do ours.
Thank you. With confidence in God's compassion and generosity, let us pray for the church, the world, and all of God's creation. God of generosity, you came to live among us in communion with us. We pray for all the congregations that be the places of welcome and belonging, where those who seek you find a home. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of creativity, you have given us a rich earth to provide all sorts of nourishment. Grant us the wisdom of good stewards in the vast and wondrous home. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of wisdom, we pray for all those who are returning to school, students, teachers, and staff. Give them the joy of learning from each other by sharing their gifts and questions. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of compassion, we pray for all those in need, both the needs we understand and the hungers that are beyond our comprehension. For all the yearning souls with true satisfaction that come from you. Especially we pray for Martin and Irene, Gary and Dixie, Lee, Julia, Marilyn, Barb, Dorothy, Iona, Lori, Pat, Melissa, Allison, Herb, Tim, Gabby, Tyler, and Felix, Forrest, Alan, and Ethan. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of community, we remember that all of the faithful who have come before us, help us to remember as they did, that who seek in the Lord that lack nothing that is good. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Into your loving hands, gracious God, we command for all those who pray, trusting in your abundant mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Now the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share that sign of peace with one another.
Thank you. Merciful God, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and our praise. It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out your Holy Spirit that by this holy communion we may know the unity we share with all your people in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The feast is ready. Come and eat.
rise to receive the blessing of the table. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Almighty God, Father and Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Today. All right, go ahead, Mason, nice and loud.
Go in peace and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.